Hey, this is Sean.
What's going on?
Jay had mentioned something about what are my five DLC-sized favorite mods for Skyrim. And so at work today, I was thinking about some of the ones I've used. And one of them, I don't know if it counts as a DLC, but it's a good story. It takes place inside of Skyrim. The other ones take place outside of Skyrim. Anyway, let's get on with it, shall we? We got Rigmor of Bruma. So you get to go to Bruma, which is what, south? I want to say Bruma. Bruma. It's south of... No, southeast, just a hair southeast of Falkreath. Once you cross the border into Cyrodiil, and Bruma's pretty big, but it's mostly about Rigmor. So you get to follow Rigmor around. That might not be a plus for some people. You're in another land. You're in a far off world from your comfy zone, which is Skyrim. You're in another land, and you're following around somebody. You're their guardian. Sound familiar? And you get to protect them as they do their story. I mean, it's bad enough that in Skyrim, you're not role-playing. You can't really role-play in Skyrim. You know, you try to role-play as close as you can, as feasible. But Skyrim, technically, you're not role-playing. You're not anything. You are nothing in Skyrim. You are no thing. You are just the interface. You are the mouse keyboard operator for Skyrim. There is somebody in the game who is Dovahkiin. And that's not you. You're able to control that character, tell them where to go, where to eat, where to sleep, where to poop. But that's not you. And, you know, you can try to... What's it called? The thing that makes you think you're inside the box when you're not. Suspension of disbelief. If you can... press your suspension of disbelief into a corner, like paint it into a corner, and you're stuck there with it, then yeah, maybe you can roleplay that Nord female is you. But technically, you're just controlling the player character, unfortunately. Even with the VR, you know, goggles, you know, the iPhone that you stick on your face and you call that VR. I want to say that's not you. You're not even inside someone's body. You're just, your camera point of view is on their forehead. What you're seeing is you've got your iPhone strapped to your face. The character in the game has their camera strapped onto their forehead, and that's what you see. Their GoPro is on their forehead, transmitting to your computer screen, and you're telling them where to go, where to run, where to, you know, who to fight, when to swing the sword. Anyway, know what I mean? I know I went on a tangent, but oh well. Anyway, Rigmor of Bruma, in my opinion, is one of the best mods of all time for Skyrim. I have not tried it yet for a special edition. I have it installed, but I haven't gone there. I've been using Rigmor in my game all the time, but I'm just using Rigmor. Using just Rigmor, which you can download. So it's just Rigmor. No mod. No mod for her. It's just her. Anyway. Next, we've got you know what this is going to be. It's Rigmor of Cyrodiil. So this is the sequel to Rigmor of Bruma. Basically, when you finish the first mod, you disable it, you know, take the check mark off its box, and then you put the check mark on this box for this mod. And you continue in this thing where it's been maybe a year has passed, and a courier runs up to you with a letter from Rigmor. She needs your help. And then you have to go, you get to go to Cyrodiil, which is more fleshed out than Bruma was. Bruma was more like the Cyrodiil wasteland. Cyrodiil is more like the imperial city part of Cyrodiil, and less of the Bruma part of this of Cyrodiil. So there's more stuff to go do and more things. And it too is, it's pretty big. It's got a big chunk of things to do. Rigmor has grown up more. She slightly sounds different, acts different, because she, you know, she's grown up since the last time you saw her. And what else? I want to say the next one's going to be Worm's Tooth. Or Worm's Stooth. I want to say it's an island, if I remember right. No, it's not make-believe. I'm guessing it's in lore-friendly territory, but it's a very, very small island. And dragons are infesting it. You have to go save them from the dragons. It's got a lot of cool special effects, some of the best terrain-looking features and assets I've ever seen. It's very diversified territory. It's got everything. It's got a little bit of... Every little piece of Skyrim you can think of is in Worm's Tooth. And I don't remember any of the NPCs. So that might be a problem. I don't remember any of the NPCs in Worm's Tooth. So they may have just been generic things that you talk to, and they all have generic faces. But it's the story that matters. And it's a good story. I brought, when I last played Worm's Tooth, I brought Mirok. I brought him with me as a follower. So that was fun. And I believe you get a house at the end of this one. As well as with Falskar, you get a house with Falskar. Maybe two houses. Now this one's kind of, it's like, it's DLC size, yeah, it's a big island, yeah. It's got NPCs that are memorable, okay. But the quests are fetch-alicious. You're going to be doing a lot of fetching, a lot. Did I mention you're going to do fetching? Anyway. And it's a lot of running back and forth across this island. Oh, you brought this many rocks. Well, I need two more of these rocks. Can you go get me two more of these rocks? And then, gotta go back to this cave on the other side of the island. Okay. So once you can speed test your way through all that, then there's a story. There's some things to do. Haunted caves everywhere. You have to go clear out haunted caves. Find out why the wolves and the chickens are being eaten, kind of a thing. But at the end, you get a house. You got some nice scenery to look at. I want to say grass mods work. Either grass mods come with Falskar, or they just work with Falskar. I can't remember. It's been years since I played Falskar. Anyway, the ones I'm showing you here are the Skyrim special edition versions. And I want to say they're written by the same guys who did the Skyrim versions. So that means they should work, I hope. You don't want to port it over DLC size mod for special edition. No, you want the original mod authors to do the conversions for their own frickin' mods. Anyway. So, Falskar, yes, I recommend playing it at least once. Maybe you like it. Maybe. If I remember right, it has dragons in it. Maybe not as many as Wormstooth did, but... Anyway, next. This one's one of my favorites. Ambriel. I know. She's not a DLC. She just works. Oh, what is it? She's a 500-year-old elven princess. And she cannot be killed. She's immortal. And it plays a lot on Highlander. It plays a lot on Star Wars. And something else. I can't remember what the other one was. But three different, I guess you would call them tropes these days. I hate the word tropes, but... You know, in a meme society, people use the word trope. So she's got some tropes that she follows along. And you know, if you've seen Star Wars at least 3 or 4 times, you'll see some of the hidden Easter eggs throughout Ambriel's adventure. But the reason why technically she's not a DLC is because she takes place in Skyrim. She doesn't have her own island. She doesn't have her own continent, her landfill, you know, none of that. She roams around Skyrim. And again, you are nobody. You are just... Think of yourself as Herodotus, the guy who... he was like the first journalist, went around following the soldiers during the War of Troy and stuff like that. He recorded some of the first histories that we know of from like 500 AD. Anyway, you're that guy, or girl, the girl version of that guy, and you follow Ambriel around while she does all the adventuring. You're just there to witness her story. it sounds kind of ridiculous, but that's a fact. That's after you're done playing her thing, you'll realize that you're just a simp in the game. But people praise this mod because they get involved with the story and they forget what's going on. They forget what's really going on. They think, oh, that was so awesome. This happened, and then that happened, and oh, my goodness. It's like coming off a Disneyland ride. All you did was sit in a chair the whole entire time. But yet, you're telling the story like, oh, and this happened, and this happened. Oh, my goodness. That's Ambriel. Lots of good, memorable NPCs. Lots of good, clever special effects, sound effects, music, lots of cool music. Lots of corny music. That's the trope parts. Anyway. Those are my 5 DLC size mods for Skyrim. Available for both Skyrim and Special Edition. Talk to you later.